Flyers, thank you. I'm going to need your help to have these knights warm up the true athletes in this game. Of course, our war horses. Everybody, a nice round of applause for our war horses, Arthur and Odin. Now, we're going to have a chance for our knights to warm up these horses in just two games before the joust, which allow them to stretch their legs. And at the same time, it'll be a lot of fun for you, the audience. Ooh. Charlie automatically throwing the gauntlet over there. Devin, you must be one heck of a kisser, because he's like, he's 350 pounds? And a terrible model. Don't move. Okay. Alright, so he's a big boy out here and with a little tiny cabbage on his head. Now don't move him. Don't move him. Okay. Now we're gonna give the knights a sharp sword. Now Audrey has a sharp sword. Now, just so you know, Audrey, Ian told me before, he goes, what, they're letting girls joust now? Yeah, I'm just letting you know that's what he said. And then he found out you're from Quebec and he does not like poutine. I know. Canada's very wholesome food and he doesn't like it. Yeah, he said poutine. That's right. Now, we're going to have Audrey ride down and try and cut that cabbage. Can she do it? Here we go. Raise your voices for Audrey. I mean, she sliced that, like, sliced thin. Hold on. Put a little piece on top. We have to be fair. We're going to go ahead and honor a time-honored tradition. You see, a knightly tradition. Back in the olden days, before a battle, quest, and tournament, knights would often venture to their own village. They would choose one lady that they would call their own queen of love and beauty, and they, of course, ride to the village, give that lady a flower.
Good thing I brought my own axe. I'm gonna hit that my little pocket, I believe.